the Buddha Puja.
Namami Buddham Gunasagarantam Santa Sada Huntu Sukhi Avera Kayo Di Guntu Sakaro Dugandho Gacchanti Sambe Maranam Mahanche Bundham 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 Vande Dhammam 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 Vande Sangham 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 Vande Bundham Dhammam Sangham Vande Homage to the Buddha, homage to the Dhamma, homage to the Sangha, homage to the Dragon. Sadhu, sadhu, sadhu.
Such indeed the exalted one, the worthy one, the supremely enlightened one. Please repeat after me. Buddham saranam gacchami. Dhammam saranam gacchami. Sangham saranam gacchami. I go to the Buddha for refuge. I go to the Dhamma for refuge. I go to the Sangha for refuge. Dutiyampi Buddham saranam gacchami. Dutiyampi Dhammam saranam gacchami. Dutiyampi Sangham saranam gacchami. A second time I go to the Buddha for refuge. A second time I go to the Dhamma for refuge. A second time I go to the Sangha for refuge. Satyampi Buddham saranam gacchami. Satyampi Dhammam saranam gacchami. Satyampi Sangham saranam gacchami. At that time, I go to the Buddha for refuge. At that time, I go to the Dhamma for refuge. At that time, I go to the Sangha for refuge. Five precepts, Panchasila. Panati Pata Veramani Sikha Padam Samadhyami. I undertake the training tool to abstain from taking life. Adinna dana veramani sikha padam samadhyami. I undertake the training tool to abstain from stealing. Kame sumichachara veramane sikha padam samadhyami. I undertake the training tool to abstain from sexual misconduct. Musavada veramane sikha padam samadhyami. I undertake the training tool to abstain from false speech. Sura meraya majya pamadattana veramane sikha padam samadhyami. I undertake the training tool to abstain from intoxicating drinks and drugs causing heedlessness. Sadhu, sadhu, sadhu. Venerable members of the Mahasangha, friends in the Dhamma, you all are warmly welcome to the Sambuddhaloka Buddhist Vihara. With the blessings of the Triple Gem, the Buddha, Dhamma, and Sangha, you are warmly welcome to the temple on behalf of Mahasangha. First of all, we are going to offer these items to the Supreme Buddha's Noble Qualities. You know, our spiritual teacher, the Supreme Buddha, has already passed away. But still, we are remembering his noble qualities. That is why we offer these items to his noble qualities. You know, dear friends, Buddha doesn't need these things. We are showing our gratitude since we receive this valuable message because of his great dedication. He practiced a lot of qualities for a long time for his enlightenment. As the result of his great dedication, he attained the enlightenment. After that, he explained this message to the world with great compassion. When we offer something to the Supreme Buddha, we contemplate on his noble qualities. The Buddha, who developed his mind to the maximum level with great compassion and wisdom. All the qualities that Buddha possessed can be summarized into 9. Iti viso bhagava araham. Such indeed the exalted one, worthy. Samma sambuddho, supremely enlightened. Vijjacharana sampanno, endowed with knowledge and conduct. Sugato, well gone. Lokavidu, knower of the world. Anuttaro purisadam sarati, incomparable trainer of persons to be tamed. Sattha deva manusvanam, the supreme teacher of deities and men. Buddho, enlightened. And Bhagava, exalted. These are the noble qualities that we contemplate on when we offer something to the Supreme Buddha. You know, offering something to the Buddha is not just a generosity, but a meditation technique. You know, Buddha Anusati Bhavana. That helps us to concentrate our mind. Buddha Anusati Bhavana helps us to purify our mind, keeping his noble qualities in our heart. Now, let's recite the gatha to offer these items to the Buddha's noble qualities. By the power of offering these items to the Blessed One, we acquire positive thoughts. By the power of this meritorious activity, especially, may your departed relatives rejoice with this merit and may they have blissful life. Finally, may they also attain the supreme bliss of liberation, Nibbana. With that intention, let's recite the gatha to offer these items to the Buddha's noble qualities. Sadhu, sadhu, sadhu. Namo tassa bhagavato arahato samma sambuddhassa. Namo tassa bhagavato samma sambuddhassa. Namo tassa bhagavato samma sambuddhassa. Iti tiso bhagava arahaṃ samma sambuddho. Vijjācharana sampanno sugato lokavidu. Anuttaro purisa dhamma sarati. Sattā deva manussānam buddho bhagavāti. Buddham jīvita pariyantam saranam gacchāmi. Vandāmi cetiyam sambhaṃ sambhatāne supatiddhitam. Sārīrika dhātu mahābodhiṃ buddha-rūpaṃ sakalaṃ. Ghanasāraṃ padintena dīpena tamadhaṃ sinā. Tilokadipam sambuddham pujayami tamonudam gandha sambhara yuntena dopenaham sugandhina pujaye pujaniyantam pujabhajana muntamam Vanna gandha guno petan etam kusuma santatin Pojayami munindansa siripada saroruhe Pojayami bundham kusumena Punyena metena ca hotu mokkham Puppan milayati yata idam me kayo tata Vinasa bhavan adivase tuno bhante paniyam parikampitam Anukampannupadaya patigannhatu muntama Adivase tuno bhante bhojanam parikampitam Anukampannupadaya patigannhatu muntama Adivase tuno bhante sambhang sandhaya pujitam Anukampannupadaya patigannhatu muntama Imina punya kammena mame bala samagamo Satam samagamo hotu yava nibbana pantiya sadhu sadhu sadhu.
Venerable members of the Mahasangha, friends in the Dhamma, Mrs. Ramani Dissanayake, beloved children, friends, relatives, all of you gathered here for a special meritorious act, offering dana to the Mahasangha. You have been doing a very special meritorious act, generosity. That is one of the main meritorious activities that we perform in Buddhist tradition. When we offer something to the Mahasangha, we have a very special chance to listening to what the Buddha explained. That is the main benefit that we receive throughout offering dana to the Mahasangha. Buddha explained his message for many years. You know, our Supreme Buddha explained his message for 45 years. All the teachings that the Buddha has explained for 45 years can be summarized into one sentence. Santutti paramandanam. Happiness is the greatest treasure. We do everything in the name of happiness. We study, we earn money, we do everything in the name of happiness. But unfortunately, most of people have lost their happiness. What is the reason that we have lost our happiness? We always think that happiness comes from outside, but happiness arises inside. We should generate it in our mind. And also, Buddha has explained the path, how we gain the real happiness. Happiness completely depends on purification of our mind. We should understand the negative thoughts that disturb our peace of mind. There are three unwholesome mental states that disturb our peace of mind. Greed, anger, and delusion. You know, we mostly think that the enemies are outside. Actually, enemies are not outside. Enemies are inside. The Buddha says, we can defeat hundreds of enemies in the battlefield, That is not the real victory. What is the real victory? The real victory is that destroying our negative thoughts, inner enemies who disturb our peace of mind. But they explain the path how we eradicate negative thoughts from our mind. When we practice generosity, when we practice moral conduct or sila, when we practice loving kindness meditation, and finally, when we practice mindfulness, we purify our mind from negative thoughts. Buddha has explained the path. Here, we start our spiritual journey practicing generosity. And also, before generosity, we should be grateful. Gratitude is the main quality. The Buddha says very clearly, all the good qualities depend on gratitude. We start our spiritual journey being grateful. Where is the place that we show our gratitude? Helping or taking care of our parents is the first step that we pay our gratitude to the world. Buddha says very clearly, Sukha matte yata loke ato pette yata sukha. It means helping or taking care of our parents is the way how we gain happiness. If we want to attain real happiness, the very first step is that being grateful to our parents. That is very important. We start our spiritual journey from our home. We should be grateful to our children, and also we should be grateful to our, especially our parents. That is very important. When we are grateful, immediately we come to the next step, that you know, generosity. Greed and gratitude are not in the same place. If we are greedy, actually we are not grateful. When we are grateful, we are generous. When we are generous, it means we meet good association, kalyana mitta. Throughout offering something to someone, we receive good friends. Through associating with good friends, we receive the noble message, a spiritual message. What the Buddha explained. This is the primary qualities that we should develop. When we are grateful, we are generous. When we practice generosity correctly, honestly, and wisely, we meet noble association who explain the spiritual path. Then we understand the spiritual path, and also we practice it, and we gain the results. Our practice completely depends on our association. Our association depends on generosity. Our generosity depends on gratitude. This is very important. And also, we are discussing the spiritual path happiness. When we are grateful, we are happy. And also, when we are generous, our mind is so pure and calm. That is why Buddhism says, Piti mudaraṁ vindati dāta. He who has a generous heart gains a lot of happiness. Since we have no negative thoughts when we practice generosity. When you offer something to the Mahāsaṅgha, your mind is so pure and calm. When you serve the monk, you are so generous, and also your mind is so pure and calm. You have no anger. At that moment, you have metta, loving kindness at that moment. This is the way how we gain the real happiness. And also, then we come to the next level, virtue or moral conduct. Sila, discipline our speech and behavior. When we speak something, when we behave, we think again and again whether it is correct. That is very important. And also, we come to the next level, practicing loving kindness meditation. Little by little we go forward on the path of liberation. Buddha says, he who wishes to attain the peace of mind should practice loving kindness meditation, contemplating on thus, may all beings be well, happy and peaceful. As the result of practicing loving kindness meditation, we make a very spiritual mind, happy mind, since we have no anger at that moment. You know, anger is one of the main reasons that disturb our peace of mind. If you are able to overcome anger, it means you can overcome more than 50% stress from your mind. That is very important. Buddha has explained the path how we make a Brahma realm in this immediate life. When we practice metta, karuna, mudita, upekkha, loving kindness, compassion, sympathetic joy, and balanced mind. As the result of practicing these four things, you know, these four things are the four sublime states that Brahmas are living with. When we practice these four things, four sublime states, we are able to make a Brahma realm in this human life. Having a human body, physically, mentally, we are in the Brahma realm. We are so fortunate. Before we die, we are able to make a Brahma realm in this immediate life. Buddha has explained the path. That is very important. And also finally, we come to the highest quality, mindfulness. Being aware of our body and mind at the present moment. Until we come to the mindfulness, we are finding happiness, but we are not experiencing the happiness. We always think that happiness will come tomorrow. That is why we always wish that adata wada honda hetak labewa. We always wish a better tomorrow than today. That tomorrow never comes. Happiness completely we should create in this moment. You know, ordinary people, always they think that happiness will come in the future. Until they die, they never experience happiness. You know, that tomorrow never comes. But when we come to the practice of Dhamma, what the Buddha explained, we come to experience the happiness. How do we experience happiness? Living in the present moment. Gradually, we trained our mind to live in the present moment. When we live in the present moment, we don't compare our past experience with the present experience. You know, if we don't compare our past experience with the present moment, we are able to overcome aging, decay, sickness, and finally death. Jara marana. You know, this is a very important message. If we live in the present moment, we are not aging. We have no the suffering of aging or decay or death. Since we live in the present moment. We come to aging because of comparing the present experience and the past experience. Buddha has explained the path how we overcome jara marana, ajara amara. Jara means decay or aging, marana means death. By practicing mindfulness, we keep our attention in the present moment completely and also we live in the present moment. As the result of practicing this path, not only mindfulness we practice, but we practice the Noble Eightfold Path. Samadhi, right understanding. Sammasankappa, right intention. Sammavacha, right speech. Sammakammanta, right action. Sammajiva, right livelihood. Sammavayama, right effort. Samma, Sati, right mindfulness, and finally Samma, Samadhi, right concentration. These 8 steps are the steps of happiness. The Noble Eightfold Path is the path of happiness. The 8 steps of happiness. You know, Buddha says very clearly, we receive the Noble Eightfold Path because of noble association, good association, Kalyana Mitta. We receive Kalyana Mitta because of practicing generosity. When we practice generosity correctly, honestly, and wisely, we meet good association who explain the path of liberation. And when we associate good friends, they explain the Noble Eightfold Path. There is a very special discourse in Buddhism, Kalyana Mitta. As the result of associating good friends, we receive the path of happiness, the Noble Eightfold Path. As the result of practicing the Noble Eightfold Path, we receive happiness, which is the main purpose of everyone who was born in this world. Our happiness depends on practicing Dhamma. It means practicing the Noble Eightfold Path. The average of practicing the Noble Eightfold Path depends on our association. Our association depends on how much we practice generosity. These are linked. That is very important. And if we haven't received the meaning of the Noble Eightfold Path, that shows our generosity is not the standard level. That is very important. When we practice generosity wisely, correctly, and honestly, we meet good association. It means we receive the spiritual message. As the result of receiving the spiritual path, we practice the Noble Eightfold Path. In short, Sila, Samadhi, Panya, virtue, loving kindness, meditation, and finally mindfulness. Mindfulness is the best friend. We usually think that best friends are outside. Actually, it may change any time. We should make a refuge friend within us. What is the best friend? Our mind. Our mind is the best friend. Buddhism says we have no real best friends outside world. We should make best friends within us. How do we make a friend? Add in mindfulness to our mind. Mind with filled happiness, mindfulness. Mind filled happiness, mindfulness. Mind filled happiness, mindfulness. It depends on in the present moment, and also the highest technique that we can develop mindfulness is that breathing meditation. Breathing meditation. That is very important. You know, when we go into old age, our children go away, we will be alone in our last moment. But our breath doesn't leave us. We are living with our breath from our birth to death. Therefore, Buddha has explained a very good meditation technique, which is anapanasati, breathing meditation, mindful breathing. If you want to see the beauty of your life, please practice mindful breathing. Then you don't find happiness from outside. Then you don't go far away seeking happiness. Happiness is at your home, with your breath, with mindfulness. Then, without wasting money and time, we can make real happiness, real friend within us, with breathing meditation. You know, when we come to the end of our life, we are struggling to live. We are struggling with our breath. If we have practiced breathing meditation, at that moment we have a refuge. We have no fear, no doubt. We can face to our last moment with happiness if we have practiced breathing meditation. You know, when we see the Buddha's message, completely Buddha's message is that mindfulness and finally mindful breathing. This is our real friend, best friend. Okay, dear friends in the Dhamma, you can be happy about this special meritorious act. Mrs. Ramani Dissanayake, children, friends, relatives, you are very good, grateful people. That is why you are performing a very special meritorious act in order to share merit with your departed relatives. That is one of the ways that we show our gratitude to our departed relatives, especially Mrs. Ramani Dissanayake hopes to transfer this marriage to her beloved husband, and children hopes to share this merit with your father, Dr. Chandra Dissanayake, and the parents of Ramani Dissanayake, and the parents of late Dr. Chandra Dissanayake, and other relatives too. Now you can be happy about this dana ceremony. You did everything in order to share merit with your departed relatives. You successfully completed this meritorious act. You can be happy for a long time about this dana ceremony. You served monk with delicious food and other things by the power of all these meritorious activities. May your departed relatives receive this merit, and finally, may they attain the supreme bliss of liberation. Sadhu, sadhu, sadhu.
Idam me nyate nam hotu sukhita huntu nyatayo. Idam me nyate nam hotu sukhita huntu nyatayo. Idam me nyate nam hotu sukhita huntu nyatayo. Yata varivaha pura paripurenti sagaram eva meva ito dinnam petanam upakabvati unname udakam vattam yata ninnam pavattati eva meva ito dinnam petanam upakabvati. Namo tasse bhagavato arahato samma sambuddhasse. Namo tasse bhagavato arahato samma sambuddhasse. Namo tasse bhagavato arahato samma sambuddhasse. Karaniya matta kusalena yantam santam padam abhisamecha sakko ujojaso Jocha suvacho chasya mudvanati mani santosya kocha subaroche appakinchocha sallahuka vunti santindriyocha nipakocha appagambo kule suvananu kindho nache kundam samachare kinchiena vinyo pare upavadeyon sukino vake mino hontu sambe sandha bhavantu sukitantaye kechi Pana Bhutanti Tasava Savarava
Anavasesadigavaye Mahantava Vajimarasya Kanukatola
Dittavaye
Vahandittaye Chadure Vasanti Avidure Bhutava Sambhavesi Vasambe
Satta
Bhavantu Sukhitantana Paroparam Nikumbeta Nati Manyeta Katta Chirankanchi
Vyarosana patiga sanya
nanya manyasa dukkha micheya mataya taniyam puttan ayusa eka putta
manurakhe
evam pi sambhute sumana sambhavaye
aparimanam
mettan cha sambhalokasmin mana sambhavaye
aparimanam
uddham adocha tiriyam cha asambhadam averam Asapattam tittam charam nisinno
vasayano vayavatas
vigatamindho etam satinna ditteya brahma
vetam
viharam idamaho dittinche anupagamma silavadassanena sampanno
kamesu vineya
gedam nahi jatu gamba seyam punare titi etena sacca vanjena Otu sambhadaye tena sancha vanjena sambhate otu sambhadaye tena
sancha vanjena otu te
jaya mangalam
dhannankaro
mahaviro medankaro mahayaso saranankaro lokahito dipankaro
jutindaro
kondanyo janapamokko mangalo purisasabho sumano sumano Diro
Revato Rati Vandano
Sobito Guna Sampanno Anomadassi Januttamo Padumo Loka Panjoto
Naradu
Varasarati Padumuttaro Santasaro Sumedho Agga Pungalo Sujato
Sambalokango
Piyadassi Narasabho Attadassi Karuniko Dhammadassi Tamonudo
Sindhato
Asamo loke tisso varada sangvaro Pusso varada sambundho vipassiche
Anupamo
Sikhi sambhaito santa Vissabhu sukhadayako Kakusandho santa Kona gamano rananjaho Kassapo siri sampanno
Gotamo
Sakya pungavo Te sansanchena silena Kantimitta
palenicha te pitvam
anurakkanto arogena sukena
chati etena saccha vanjena dukkha
upasamintu te etena saccha vanjena bhaya upasamintu
te
etena saccha vanjena roga upasamintu te
ayu vaddako
dhana vaddako siri vaddako
Vandako, Bale Vandako, Vanna Vandako, Sukha Vandako, Hotu Sambhada, Dukkha Roga, Baya Vera, Soka, Sambhe,
Upandava,
Aniga, Antaraya, Phi, Virasantu, Chatejasa, Jaya, Sindhi, Dharang, Labhang, Swatti, Bhagyang, Sukham,
Balang,
Siriyayuche, Vanno, Che, Bhogang, Buddhi, Che,
Yasava,
Satavasa, Che, Ayu,
Yoche
jiva sindhi bhavantu te
rajato va
chorato va
manusato va
amanusato va
angito va
udakato va
pisachato va
kanukato va
kantakato
va
nakkatato
va
janapadarogato va asandhammato
va
asandittito va
asapurisato
va
chandasi
asamiga gora
kukura
Ayi vichika
mani sappadipi
Atta taraccha
sukara
Mahisayakka
rakka
sadhi
Nana
bayato
va
Nana
rogato
va
Nana
upadavato
va
Arakkan ganhanto
Sambhitiyo
vivajjanto Sambarogo
vinasato
Mate
bhatvantarayo
Sukhidigayo
bhava
bhavatu sambha mangalam rakkhantu sambha devata sambha buddhanubhavena sadasvati bhavantu te bhavatu sambha mangalam rakkhantu sambha devata sambha dhammanubhavena sadasvati bhavantu te bhavatu sambha mangalam rakkhantu sambha devata sambha sanghanubhavena sadasvati
bhavantu te nakkhattayakka
bhutanam papangani varana paretasanubhavena
hantu te sannupandave akasattacha bhummatta
devanaga
mahindika punyantam
anumoditva chiram rakkhantu loka sasanam akasattacha bhummatta devanaga
mahindika punyantam
anumoditva chiram rakkhantu desanam akasattacha bhummatta devanaga
mahindika
punyantam anumoditva
chiram rakkhantu mam param Abhivadana
silissa nicchaṁ buddha pachāyino chattāro dhammā vaddanti āyuvanno
sukhaṁ balaṁ sambhītiyo
vivajjanto sambha rogo vinassato māte bhavatvantrayo sukhi dīghāyo ko